Chris Gambit here for B&H, talking to you about tuning up your DSLR's autofocus. Sometimes when you're taking a picture, the focus may not be on the specific spot you wanted it to be. Maybe the focus is off by a couple of millimeters forward or backward, which is enough to create an out-of-focus image. If you find this happening often, you'll need to tweak the autofocus. Before you do this, you should first check to see if your camera can adjust the autofocus settings. This is usually in the custom menus. Consult the index of your manual if you're not sure. With Canon, this is called AF micro-adjustment, and with Nikon, this is called AF fine-tuning. To do this successfully, you'll want to use an item like the Spider lens cowl and set it up on a tripod or flat surface. Have the lens that you want to use attached to the DSLR and set the camera up on a level surface with the calibration target. The camera should be no less than 50 times the focal length away from the lens calibration target. For telephoto lenses longer than 200 millimeters, a distance of 25 times the focal length is more practical. Since I'm using a 35mm f1.4L wide-angle lens, it should be 35 times 50, which is 1,750 millimeters. That's 1.75 meters, which is approximately 5 feet 9 inches. Focus on the center of the target and make sure the lens is wide open and the camera is parallel to the calibration target. Shoot in reasonably bright light, and also use a low ISO setting to reduce the image noise. Check your exposure to make sure it's reasonably accurate. I usually try to read the histogram in this case. Be sure to manually select your camera's center focusing point. Also be sure to select an appropriate AF mode. For EOS cameras, one-shot AF is best for the test. For Nikon SLRs, use single servo AF. Results may not be as reliable in other autofocus modes or with other autofocus points. For the best results, I usually set my camera to the self-timer delay shooting mode or use an electronic cable release and switch to mirror lockup mode. This ensures that there is no camera shake at all. When I do this, I usually have my camera tethered to my computer as well as using a remote live view so that I can inspect the images very carefully. From this, I decide whether or not I need to adjust my camera to focus forward or backward. It's usually a good idea to do this in 2mm intervals. Something to keep in mind is that this works best with prime lenses only. Zoom lenses have multiple focal lengths, and it's often easier to just send the lens back to the manufacturer for recalibration. If you want to learn more about tweaking your camera's autofocus or the lens cowl, give us a call, visit us online, or stop by our New York City superstore. I'm Chris Gambit, and thanks for watching.